Hi, it's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, chemistry PhD, skincare nerd, and I don't think I smell that much. Today we're talking about armpit stink. You might have seen a lot of natural deodorants on the market, and you might have been wondering, do you really need to switch? Is there any truth to the idea that aluminium's bad for you? This is the video for you. If you like nerding out about the science behind beauty products, click the like, the subscribe, and click the notification bell so you don't miss any videos. Aluminium compounds are found in lots of antiperspirant products, and the main reason they're in there is to stop you from sweating as much and cut down on body odor. These are ingredients like aluminium chlorohydrate. These interact with water and they form a plug in your sweat gland, and so that stops the sweat from coming out. This plug comes out naturally later when your skin cells shed, and this is what keeps your armpits dry. With body odor, there are two main ingredients that combine to make you stink: odor-forming chemicals or odor precursors that are found in some types of sweat, and the right kind of bacteria, mostly Chironibacteria, and also Staphylococci. Basically, larger molecules can't evaporate as easily, so they can't make it to your nose where you can smell it. In fresh sweat, the odor molecules are part of a larger molecule. They need the bacteria to come along and chop off the odor molecule to free it, and then it can drift off into your nose and make you stink. So without the bacteria, the sweat won't smell, and without the sweat, the bacteria has nothing to chop up and cause stank. The aluminium-based plugs block the sweat, and so there's less fuel for the bacteria to turn into odor. It also makes your armpits less damp, and so it's a less friendly environment for bacteria to sit around and poop out stink. So overall, these aluminium salts are a super effective way of cutting down on stink. But like with any other unnatural sounding ingredient, there's been a lot of fear-mongering around aluminium. I think this is the scariest claim, that aluminium is linked to breast cancer. But pretty much all reputable sources says there's no link. So the Canadian Cancer Society says, there is no evidence that the use of antiperspirants increases your risk for breast cancer. There is no link between aluminium and breast cancer risk. The American Cancer Society says, there are no strong epidemiologic studies in the medical literature that link breast cancer risk and antiperspirant use, and very little scientific evidence to support this claim. Cancer Research UK says, there is no good evidence that aluminium in deodorants could increase the risk of cancer in animals or humans. The National Cancer Institute says, no scientific evidence links the use of these products to the development of breast cancer. No studies to date have confirmed any substantial adverse effects of aluminium that could contribute to increased breast cancer risks. In late 2019, the European Commission's Scientific Committee on Consumer Safety re-evaluated aluminium in antiperspirants. And again, they concluded that they were safe in the amounts used in cosmetics. So that's around 6% in non-spray antiperspirants and 10% in spray antiperspirants. A number of scientific reviews over the years have found that there's no clear evidence that using aluminium antiperspirants increases the risk of breast cancer. The 2008 review made a very bold statement: after analysis of the available literature on the subject, no scientific evidence to support the hypothesis was identified, and no validated hypothesis appears likely to open the way to interesting avenues of research. So if you've ever interacted with scientists, you'll know that it takes a lot for a scientist to say there is absolutely nothing, and even more to make a scientist say that there is no point in further researching a topic. So where did this myth come from, and why does it keep persisting? If you've been following any sort of ingredient fearmongering in beauty or anywhere else, you'll know that this is usually how it goes. An in vitro study suggests a possible link. The conditions in the in vitro study didn't really reflect the reality of how that ingredient's used. People ran with it anyway. Large-scale population studies didn't find a link, but no one cares anymore because everyone is already freaking out. So here's the evidence for aluminium being linked to breast cancer. Firstly, breast cancer tumours are usually found near the armpit. Breast cancer tumours are usually found in the upper outer quadrant of the breast. That's right next to the armpit, and so people started wondering if some of the so-called unnatural things we used in our armpits could be linked. A more likely explanation that most medical people point out is that there's simply more tissue in that area. The quadrants aren't all evenly sized, and so if you have more cells in the upper outer quadrant, that's where you're more likely to find cancer. More cells means more cancer. Secondly, aluminium has had effects on cells in vitro studies. Some in vitro studies have found that aluminium can affect how estrogen receptors function. Since the hormone estrogen has been found to increase the growth of breast cancer, this could be interpreted as evidence that aluminium could be linked to breast cancer. Aluminium has also been found to damage DNA in cells. But there are a lot of reasons why these in vitro results don't translate to how we use antiperspirants on our skin. For aluminium to have effects on living cells, it would have to be absorbed into your skin at a high enough concentration. But the aluminium salts used in antiperspirants don't absorb well into skin at all. One study estimated that only 0.012% of the applied aluminium actually absorbed into skin. Most of our exposure to aluminium is actually through food, and it's estimated that the amount that you get from antiperspirants versus the amount that you get from food, it's about 2.5%. So there really isn't a lot more aluminium in your body if you're using an antiperspirant. The study that found the DNA damage used a really high concentration, much higher than you'd ever find in the body. In standard tests, aluminium didn't have any effect on cancer-causing mutations. Another piece of evidence that gets brought up is that aluminium concentrations are higher in cancer tissue, sometimes. So some studies have found that there's high aluminium in breast cancer tissue, but other studies haven't found this association. In a really famous 2007 study, there were 17 cancer patients and they examined their breast cancer tissue. The aluminium was slightly higher in the outer region, but they didn't compare it with other parts of the body or with people who didn't have breast cancer. A 2011 study found higher aluminium in nipple aspirate from women with breast cancer than those without. A 2013 study looked at breast tissue from people with breast cancer, and they didn't find any difference in aluminium between the cancerous parts and the non-cancerous parts. Other scientists have also mentioned that maybe breast cancer tissue just collects more aluminium than other tissue. This happens with some other substances. So what do the human studies tell us? The best way to check if something causes something in humans is by looking at actual humans, and the more of them you have, the better. A 2002 study compared about 800 women with breast cancer and 800 women without, and they found no link between breast cancer risk and the use of antiperspirants or deodorants. A 2003 study looked at questionnaires from about 400 women with breast cancer. They found that women who used antiperspirant and deodorant and shaved their armpits had an earlier age of diagnosis. But some other experts have pointed out some problems with this study that would limit how we can interpret the results. So for example, it didn't look at how often women without breast cancer use these products. It could also just be saying that women who use a lot of deodorant tend to be younger. A 2006 study compared 54 women with breast cancer and 50 without, and they didn't find that the women with breast cancer used antiperspirants more. But they did find an association with family history and the use of oral contraceptives. So based on all this evidence, it doesn't seem like there's much of a link between using antiperspirants with aluminium and getting breast cancer in humans with real-world usage. So why is the link between aluminium and breast cancer so persistent? A number of cancer experts and institutions have pointed out that it is one particular research group who keeps on researching the supposed link between aluminium and breast cancer. And this is despite other scientists saying that the link is pretty darn unconvincing, to the point where it's not really worth investing more resources into studying it. This group is the DARPA group. You might remember them as the people who started the fear-mongering about parabens based on a really flawed study. Their publications on aluminium keep on emphasizing the in vitro evidence, even though other studies strongly indicate that these in vitro studies don't translate to what actually happens in humans. It's really hard to be convinced that there is a link between aluminium and breast cancer. There are glaring issues with the experimental design of a lot of the studies that have supposedly found a link. And if you study something enough, you'll inevitably find correlations that will support your case. It's comforting to think that we can be completely in control when it comes to whether or not you get a disease. But the reality is, a lot of the time it's completely arbitrary or out of our control. It's impossible to say what exactly caused a particular case of cancer, and it's usually not very helpful either. A lot of people who have all of the risk factors for cancer never end up developing cancer. I'm sure we all know someone who smoked continuously and never got lung cancer. But it can be useful to know the risk factors so that you can improve your chances against cancer. We know that breast cancer risk is mostly associated with things that are outside of our control. Some of these are being female, being older, being Caucasian, having a family history of breast cancer, certain genetic factors, menstruating before age 12 and having menopause after age 55, never having given birth, being older when you have your first child, and having dense breast tissue. There are also some environmental and lifestyle factors that are more within our control that are also linked with breast cancer. Sedentary lifestyle, so not exercising much, poor diet, drinking alcohol, being overweight, having ionizing radiation in the chest area, and having hormone replacement therapy. These lifestyle factors are generally a lot harder to change than just switching your deodorant. So the narrative that such a simple change can significantly help us against something as scary as cancer is really alluring, even though the scientific evidence just doesn't add up. And unfortunately, this sort of convenient lie can make us a bit complacent and not act on the things that we should actually be acting on. There are a few other myths about why you shouldn't use aluminium, but here's the reality. Not sweating is actually fine. There's a myth that because antiperspirants block sweat, then it stops your body from getting rid of toxins. But your body mostly gets rid of toxins through your kidneys, they put into pee, or your liver, which puts it into your poop. Sweating plays an incredibly minor role. The main function of sweat is just to cool you down, not to actually flush out toxins. And you are sweating on the rest of your body anyway, there's no reason why the toxins have to come out through your armpits. Sometimes this myth also involves some talk of lymph nodes, so lymph nodes in your armpits are supposedly important for clearing toxins, and the aluminium stops them from working. But the lymph nodes aren't actually connected to your sweat glands. So there are some valid reasons for avoiding aluminium. If your skin is sensitive to aluminium if they cause a rash, then obviously you shouldn't use it. If armpit sweat isn't a problem for you, then there's no reason for you to use it. If antiperspirants aren't working well enough for you, then maybe you should look at other options like perhaps Botox injections. If you have incredibly poor kidney function, then you might want to avoid extra aluminium. You'll be doing this in your diet as well. If you're about to go for a breast screen, then your doctor might tell you to avoid using aluminium. But the reason for this is that it can show up on images and make them confusing to interpret. It's not because it's causing breast cancer. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up and you can subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment letting me know what other myths you want me to bust. You can follow me on Instagram and check out my blog for more on the science behind beauty products. And I'll see you next time to nerd out more. Epidemiologic.